me crazy. I dream about our babies, gazing on days and contagious. Show my baby. YouTube, it's your girl Asia,
and it's your boy BJ,
back in the building,
back in effect,
back like we never left.
And y'all, we appreciate y'all for hitting that thumbnail. Man, we continue on as music continues to create conversation. Today we're going to be jumping into Neil Diamond, and the title of this one is I Am, I Said.
Okay.
Neil Diamond, I know, I'm familiar with Neil Diamond. I know who he is.
I've never heard of him before.
I've heard of Neil Diamond. I couldn't tell you a song per se, but I have heard of him.
Okay.
So this will be, I think this will be our first Neil Diamond song.
I do. He has an attractive name. Neil Diamond.
Yeah.
Shoot, I want to know about Neil Diamond. Shoot.
Okay. We have to tap in.
Yeah. All right. So make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe. Let's go ahead and jump into this video, y'all.
Hey, another pull-up session, y'all. Let's get into it. You ready?
Let's go.
Okay.
LA's fine, the sun shines most of the time, and the feeling is laid back. Palm trees grow and rents are low, but you know, keep thinking about making my way back. Well, I'm New York City born and raised, but nowadays I'm lost between two shores. LA is fine, but it ain't home. New York's home, but it ain't mine no more. I am myself to no one there, and no one heard at all, not even the chair. I cried, I am, said I, and I am lost, and I can't even say why. Leaving me lonely still, did you ever read about a frog who dreamed of being a king and then became one? Well, except for the names and a few other changes, if you talk about me, the story's the same one.
Story, exact same one. I'm trying to tell you. Now, this kind of reminds me of like somebody kind of being lost, just kind of being lost in life to a degree, you know, kind of up and moving to somewhere else, moving to a, because he said it right there, he's in LA.
Mm-hmm. And from New York.
So it kind of feels like, you know, his mind is in LA, but his heart is still in New York.
Yeah.
Like he just longs to be back home. That's kind of what I'm just picking up, just, you know, just kind of with the first couple of minutes that we're listening to it.
That's kind of, that's like really sad. I mean, that's kind of like what I'm picking up too, in terms of like him just feeling like alone. He's like not even the chair. Like, y'all,
not even the chair.
It can't be more like more sad than that. Like when you feel like you are that lonely and not even the chair is there to even care.
Not even the chair is there to listen.
To listen to, you know what I'm saying? He was like, my story is basically, he said, a few other changes. If you talk about me, the story is the same. Mm-hmm. Which means like he doesn't have any other story to tell you, but he feels the same way regardless of where he goes. Like. Mm-hmm. Man, ooh-wee.
He's longing to be back in New York, but he still said, you know, New York is no longer mine either, so.
Right. Man, that's sad.
Me. The story's the same one. But I got an emptiness deep inside that I've tried, but it won't let me go. And I'm not a man who likes to swear, but I never cared for the sound of being alone. I am, I say. chair. I am, I cried. I am, said I. And I am lost, and I can't even say why. I am, I said.
So sad. That's messed up.
Aww. I love the tone. I love like the tone of his voice, because it really resonated with me, because he was able to really get that message across, especially like vocally, because you could kind of hear like the angst. You could feel like the loneliness in his tone, mm-hmm. and even especially in the lyrics, obviously.
Yeah.
But you know, it just sounds like somebody just longing to be back home, and wherever he's at, he just has nobody to vent to or talk to.
I think he's just longing for anybody.
That's what I'm saying.
Honestly, like yeah. regardless of like where he is, you know what I mean? Like to the point to where he like I'm, you know, I cried too. Like I cried. Like dang, like that's just a really bad place to be. Okay, just literally just a bad place to be.
Yeah, I mean, especially mentally, because yeah. like I said, you can hear it. You can just hear it in his tone.
Wow.
Especially when you get to the point where you're like, nobody's even there, nobody's even listening, not even the chair. So it kind of puts it kind of in a place of like him being somewhere in his home and just there by itself.
Yeah.
You know,
I mean, in
complete utter silence.
I can kind of relate to that a little bit.
Complete loneliness.
I know what that feels like.
Yeah.
You know, especially when there is somebody there that doesn't care about anything that you got going on. Nothing. Not even to talk to you. Okay. If you're hungry, if you're thirsty, if you're sad, if you're happy, mm-hmm. if you not like, you know what I mean? Like, I feel like that's even worse when there is a person there or people that are there that don't care. Mm-hmm. They literally don't care. And that's worse to me than not having anybody. Like, at least if there's nobody there, you don't even feel tempted to try to engage and conversate with somebody. But if there's somebody there and they just literally just don't care as if you don't even exist, literally don't exist, that's the worst. Like, I feel like that's even worse.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, absolutely. Especially if you do have people there. But yeah, I just feel like the tone of his voice, like he just has nobody. You don't even have a chair to vent to. That's mm-hmm. what I'm saying. Like that can be a very, very lonely place when you don't have anybody to actually verbalize your thoughts to, and it's always kind of here in your head. And you know, when it's here, it just keeps going around and around and around because you can't release it. So
yeah, a lot of the times, like, it's not always good thoughts, because essentially you start off trying to be positive and keeping up, you know, your sanity in terms of not having that. But then eventually it feels like it starts evolving into, you know, things like doubt, you know, just insecurities, just everything mm-hmm. that would take over somebody, you know what I mean? And especially when you know that you're not being heard and nobody is there to listen, you know it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, hey, great song. I loved his vocals too on this. Like you said, I really could hear like the, you know, the cry in this, like the pain, mm-hmm. you know, the emotion, if you will. But this was nice. I even the musicality part of it, like, what's crazy is like it kind of still gave you like an almost like a upfilled, like an upbeat fulfilled sadness. if that's a thing, like, you know, because it had a bunch of like, you know, classical type of sounds to the music, the you know, in terms of how you heard the music. If you took out the words and you were listening to the music, you'd be like, oh, okay. Like
classic.
Oh, it's classical nice. Music. You know what I mean? But then what he was saying, I just felt like that just kind of just, whoop. You know what I mean? Like, put the cap on that, yep. you know?
And anybody that's kind of in that same mental headspace, they'll definitely gravitate towards the song, because it's like, it's talking directly to that particular person. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah. So, you know, I'm here if you need me. Y'all can just email me if you're out there by yourself all lonely and stuff. I'll talk to you, okay? Just say it. You want to talk too, babe? No? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What'd you say? What are you talking about?
No, my bad. Anyway, if y'all enjoyed this video, be sure you give us a big thumbs up, like, comment, and subscribe. Hit the notification bell.
Absolutely.
Join the family. And if ain't nobody told you, I love you. And we're going to see y'all in the next video. Yo.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Appreciate y'all for tuning in.
Yeah. Bye.
Lost in your body, boy, I'm addicted. Insisting commitment, predicted your intentions.